Welcome to this video. In this we are going to see how to examine eye and ear.
Do you wear any spectacles or contact lens?
No.
Okay.
Washing our hands is mandatory before and after the examination. First, let us go with Snellen's chart for visual acuity. Close your left eye and you read this.
E F P T O Z L P E D.
Yeah, okay. Close the opposite eye and you read this.
O L E D.
Now we will check visual field by static finger wiggling test.
I'm closing my left eye. You close your right eye. You want to say where my hands are swiggling.
No. No.
Okay. Now we will repeat for the opposite eye. And it will continue simultaneously.
Now, kinetic red target test. You assume my nose as a focal point and say where this will appear red. Take my nose as a focusing point.
No. 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 No.
Now we will check pupillary reflection. For that, first we need to darken the room. First, I am checking the left eye of the patient.
This is direct pupillary reflection. Now, the right eye of the patient, consensual pupillary reflection.
Now, swinging light test.
Now, accommodation reflex. To check constriction and convergence of the pupil. Look at the tip of my finger. Now full. Please stop. Now full range eye movement at a distance. Double vision. Look the tip of my finger where it moves.
Now whisper test. I'm standing back side of the patient. Now I am closing his ear with my finger. Now you repeat what I am saying.
Cat.
1.
53.
Now I am repeating this for the opposite ear. Watch.
Watch.
Pen.
70.
Thank you.
This is tuning fork. I am using 512 headset. Now we are going to check Weber's test. I will click this using my fingers or tap on the knee, and I will place on the patient's face or head, and he will say whether he can sense it or not.
I am clicking this. Now I am tapping the tuning fork on my knee.
Okay. Yes.
Rini's test, which is taken
behind the ear in mastoid process. Again, I am tapping the fork.
Yes.
This is to check air conductance using tuning fork.
Yes.
Can you sense it?
Yes.
Now checking the internal ear of the patient using this otoscope. For inspecting middle ear, straighten the ear canal to insert the otoscope. For this, I am holding this with my right hand for the right ear and placing my little finger on the cheek of the patient for getting support. Now I am turning on the light and pushing this inside his ear.
I did not notice any abnormalities and you are fine.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
There is no abnormalities in patient's eyes and ears. Thank you for watching this video. Keep supporting.